Welcome to the Zhanjiang Sports Center, host venue for judo at these Chengdu Games. Huge complex that comprises the diving competition next door as well. First up, it's the men's under 90 kilo. The first contest for a bronze medal between Kazakhstan's Beygazi and Japan's Nakanishi. Bronze medal match number one then in the under 90 kilo category for men. Beygazi of Kazakhstan up against Nakanishi of Japan. And already Ishido, a warning to the Japanese judoka. Oh, an early attack, and he got the throw in. A very quick result for Kazuki Nakanishi, who takes the first bronze in the men's under 90 kilo category. In the second bronze medal match in the under 90 kilo, it's Mark van Dijk of the Netherlands. He faces this man in blue, Elian Haliyev. Oh, fantastic throw from the Dutchman. And no doubt about it, it is an ippon from the Uchigari for Mark van Dijk. So a bronze medal for the Netherlands. And so we come to the final of the under 90 kilo category for men to decide the gold and silver medals. Oh, an early throw and wazari for the Korean. Love to see that one again. I'm sure we will later. I think it was just an Oso Tagari that just caught Goz out. So clearly Han came out to go on the attack right from the start. And we didn't see it on the screen, but the referee has stopped it, and I think he's given the Hungarian an ippon. I saw his arm go up briefly. We'll just wait for confirmation. So Roland Goss started so well, notched up a wazari, and finished it off with an ippon. Our medalists in the men's under 90 kilo category. An 11th judo medal of the games for Japan. It also happens to be their first bronze. But congratulations to Roland Goz of Hungary for winning his country's first judo gold here in Chengdu. Time now for the first of two bronze medal matches in the under 78 kilo women's category. Dudenaitė of Lithuania, and she faces Erdinat Od Batbaya of Mongolia. Oh, she attempts the Tominagi, but it goes wrong big time, and now Batbaya has the hold on. 10 seconds for Wazari. And Dudanaitė of Lithuania is not going to be getting out of that. 5 more seconds. And the bronze medal goes to Mongolia. Erdenet Od Batbaya of Mongolia gets the country's second bronze in judo. So on to our second contest for the second bronze medal in this category. Rafaela Eagle of Germany and Océane Zachibi of France. Oh, she goes in. Trying to find an arm lock, trying to turn her over for a hold, seeing what the possibilities are there. Now, how long will the referee let this go on for? Oh, there's an... Oh, we have an injury. The medic's called on. The victory and the bronze medal goes to Rafaela Eagle of Germany. Time for the final now of the women's under 78 kilo category. Sees Japan up against Korea. Sugimura, Boyd with, oh, doesn't manage to turn her over in the throw. The Korean stays face down. But yes, Sugimura hugely confident right now following a bronze at the Japanese national championships a few months ago. Well, that's been given as a Wazari, and the hold is on. So Sugimura needing to hold the Korean down for another few seconds, and that's it. It's another gold medal for Japan in the judo. Mizuki Sugimura, 19 years old, takes gold here. It was a great throw that gained her a Wazari, and then the holds for a second Wazari. Four medalists in the women's under 78 kilo category, and second left with the gold is Mizuki Sugimura, holding Japan's 5th women's judo gold of the game so far. Coming up next, the 3 matches to decide the medals in the men's under 100 kilo category. First up, Sadwakas of Kazakhstan against Livez of France. So Livez has no more chances, and it would be a shame to go out on a disqualification, but right now he's got bigger concerns. The hold is on and the Frenchman is struggling. There's no getting out of that. I think this is going to Sadwakas. But that is a bronze for Kazakhstan. Kilian Baltuis against Batkuyag of Mongolia. Oh, the Mongolian changed tactic there, changed his handhold, got the throw in. And it's a nip on to the Mongolian. We wait for confirmation. There is, of course, a video commission sitting by the mat, watching the replays, just making sure. The referee on the mat waiting for confirmation. And there it comes. It's the bronze medal. The bronze medal to Batkuyag of Mongolia. And so we move to the final now of the men's under 100 kilo category. Green of Japan up against Petter Silke of Germany. He wants them to check an illegal sleeve hold. All clear. Japan looking to add to their ninth, nine gold medals in the judo here. Ten seconds to go, they're running out of time. Mate. Oh, another Shido. Oh my goodness. What a way to be defeated. An illegal sleeve hold. And the victory goes to Germany. Falk Petter Silke claims Germany's first judo gold at these games. Germany celebrate their first judo gold of the games, thanks to Falk Petter Silke. And it also moves Germany to third in the current judo medal table. Up next, the medal matches to decide the women's over 78 kilo category. Bakerke Ramazanova and Agat Martin Silva of Brazil. Ramazanova has got a good grip on that collar, is controlling Martin Silva. Oh, but not for long. Martin Silva with that terrific throw. There's a nip on the board and it's official, a nip on it is. And a bronze medal for Agatha Martin Silva of Brazil. Second contest for the second bronze medal in the women's over 78 category. And this will see Simonetti of Italy up against Dambadaj A of Mongolia. Now, can Simonetti, without her coach, can she pull something out of the bag with just the last 10 seconds to go? So clock stopped on 2 seconds. Looks like we're going to go to golden score. Oh no, well, no we're not. It's a third Shido and disqualification for Italy's Erica Simonetti. Wow, what a way to lose a medal. Second disqualification we've seen this afternoon in the judo. The crowd has come to life because they have a Chinese judoka in a final. Jia Chundi of China in the white faces this lady, Setbiol Park, who also gets a huge cheer. And I have to admit, like a lot of these Chinese athletes, we really don't know that much about her. They keep themselves to themselves. There's not much information on them. So let's see what she's made of. And straight away, there's plenty of action on the mat. First attempted throw goes in. The Korean last year managing fifth in the Asian Championships. So well known to the crowd. Well, if 3,000 people can will somebody over on the mat, it's going to happen here. Both women then guaranteed a medal, but what colour will it be? Gold or silver? Just a minute gone. Both of them have tested each other. Both of them are coming up with strategies. An attempt at the Aponcianagi from Chun Dijia. Oh, she's got the arm lock on. And Park submits. And it is gold for China. A terrific performance. And confirmation on the screen and for the crowd that Chun Dijia has won gold for China. A huge smile from her. Well, the biggest cheer of the day, in fact the whole judo competition so far, is for Jia Chundi, who took China's first judo medal at these Chengdu Games. Time now to decide the medals in the final category of the day in the men's over 100 kilo category. It's Surowski of Poland against Sipocz of Hungary. Well, he found that throw out of nowhere, Kasper Surowski. And no doubt in the referee's mind that that was worth a nippon. And so it's a bronze medal to the Pole. The next will be decided between a Georgian and a Mongolian. As the tiredness kicks in, this is when they have to stay concentrated. Just slightest lapse could cost them the match and a medal. And he's given a Wazari. He's given the Wazari to the Georgian. Demetrishvili thinks he's got it. He thinks it was good enough. And it is. And the referee holds up his arm and the victory goes to Irakli Demetrishvili of Georgia. Bronze medal thanks to Wazari in golden score. And so we come to the final match of the day, and it is the final in the over 100 kilogram category for men. Nakamura of Japan up against Kim of Korea. Japan with 9 gold medals already in the games in judo. Can they add to that tally? Certainly favourites for the team events tomorrow. A very good start for In Jong Kim. Wazari is still in the early stages of this fight. Trying the Koso Tagaki. Doesn't quite come off though. Oh, he puts another throw in. It was a Wazari up already, and halfway through the match, In Jong Kim believes he's won it. We believe he's won it. We have to wait for confirmation from the referee. It is gold for Min Jong Kim. First he scored a Wazari early on, and then at the halfway stage he throws for a Nippon, and the 22-year-old has won the gold. So a big well done to our medalists in the plus 100 kilo category. In the men's, it was bronze medals for Poland and Georgia, a silver for Japan, and congratulations to Min Jong Kim of Korea for sealing Korea's second judo gold of the competition.